Hello and welcome back to SAS Bootcamp week 4 homework video. So this week we are not doing an exercise. Instead, we are moving directly into homework. The only two concepts that you are learning this week are how to do arrays and how to do the merge, as shown on your note screen right here. For those of you that do not have access to this file, you are welcome to pause the video at this point, and then you can come back to it as you need at a later time. But I want to walk you through the homework. The homework for this week is going to be a little elaborate. And I've tried to do it this way so that you can utilize several of the things you are learning this week, but also apply things we've learned in the previous weeks in order to complete this homework. Right? So for this week's homework, you are supposed to use two data sets, the patient underscore info data set and the Rx claims data set. Both of those files were actually used in the content videos for this week, so you should be familiar with them. And if you haven't watched the content videos, please go watch them before you come to the homework video. Okay, so you are going to use both of those data sets. The objective for this homework is this: for all continuously eligible adults, for all 7 months that are available in the data set, calculate percentage of days that they took their medication without a gap. Which means I want to know if once the individual has started taking their medications, how many days they took their medication without having a gap. If they ever have a gap, then you need to stop counting how many days they had that medication and you need to calculate that percentage. Instead of just leaving you guys with that objective, I'm actually going to give you the steps for getting there. So these steps are elaborately described in this screen right here. So go ahead, pause, take a screenshot of this if you need to, and then please try to work on this homework before Friday. Let me know if you have questions, and as usual, I'm willing to repeat these topics that we've covered this week or other things if you have questions about them. And then on Friday, I will upload a second video which actually talks about how to accomplish this homework. All right, so here are the steps. The first step, you should use your patient info file and use your regular if, then, or where statements to delete any individuals that are not adults in your data set. So you remember that there is a date of birth variable in your patient info file. Use the date of birth variable to identify individuals that are adults and delete anybody that's not an adult. Second step, identify individuals who are continuously eligible for all 7 months of the study period. So you want individuals that are eligible for all 7 months. Being eligible for any less than 7 means they need to be deleted. Next, step 3, for each eligible adult individual, so once those step 1 and 2 are completed, you have an eligible population, if you will. For that eligible population, identify all the prescription claims. You need to do this by merging your patient eligible individuals data set, the one from step 1 and step 2, with your Rx claims files. And you can use a left merge when you do that merge to exclude the claims related to individuals that are not eligible. Right? So anybody that are not eligible, we don't care about their claims files. So if they are not an adult and if they are not enrolled in the insurance for all 7 months, we don't care about their prescription claims. You can go ahead and delete those right away using a left merge. Once you've got all the claims for the eligible population, move on to step 4. In step 4, you need to create a possession array for 210 days. 210 days is what I'm using here because 7 months, I'm saying roughly 30 days in every single month. So we are interested in a possession array for 210 variables, 210 days. So go ahead and create that possession array. In one of the videos this week, we talked about how to do that using arrays and do loops. Go ahead and refer back to that video if you need to, but that's basically what you need to do here. In step 5, once you have that possession array, if you remember, is going to be at each prescription level, right? Each prescription for each individual has a possession array that goes from day 1 to day 210. Now you need to start rolling those up. So you need to think about buckets, which is what we did in the previous week's video, where we talked about first dot and last dot variables, and you need to combine individuals from multiple rows to one row. So if individual one has 5 prescriptions, you need to go from 5 rows to one row of data. Right? That's your task for step 5. And if you want to accomplish this, you can use the retain function along with the first dot and last dot variables, or you can use the sum statement if you want to do that. I prefer using the first retain function with first and last variables. If you still have questions or if you're not clear about how to accomplish that, please refer to last week's videos. Next, step 6, Then you are going to identify the number of days of continuous fills, right? Continuous fills, as in once an individual has started therapy, if they have a gap in therapy, before I go there, in step five, when you bring those number of rows down to one, make sure that you are summing these rows. So those 210 variables, you need to sum them for each and every individual. All 210 variables need to sum, right? Then you will get to a data set which will have one row for every individual of data. Once you accomplish that, then in step six, you need to identify number of days of continuous fills. So you need to start counting fills or counting these continuous fills after an individual has picked up their first prescription. So don't just start from day one, start from whatever day they got their first prescription. If they got their first prescription on day 15 or day 85, that's when you need to begin counting continuous fills, right? Begin counting continuous fills from there onwards. And whenever an individual has a zero in their possession array, because they probably ran out of their previous prescription and didn't come back to the pharmacy to pick up their next prescription in time, they will have a zero. That zero is a gap in therapy. And when you see the first zero, stop counting number of days. And that will give you the number of days of continuous fills. There are multiple ways to do this. In our week's videos, we have talked about how to do continuous eligibility. Doing continuous fills is very similar to that. So you can use an approach similar to that and go back to refer to that video if you want ideas for how to accomplish this. Once you've done that, next, in order to calculate that percentage, you need a denominator. And the denominator is the duration of therapy. To calculate duration of therapy, you can do one of two different things, right? The first thing, you can go back to your original Rx claims file, and then you can identify the date of the first prescription fill and the date of the last prescription fill and subtract those two dates to get the duration of therapy. If you do that, because you will be working off of a different claims file, you will have to merge this file back with your file that has the days of continuous fills to include that variable. So you can use this option, but I think it's a little more work to do that. The second thing you can do if you don't want to use that option is you can use the 210 variable possession array to basically identify the date of the first fill and the date of the last fill. So whichever one you want to use is okay with me. Just make sure you identify the total duration of therapy so that you can have a denominator to calculate your percentage. Once you've done step six and step seven, you now have both the numerator, which was in step six, and the denominator, which was calculated in step seven. And you should now have a row where for every single individual, you have one row of data that includes both the numerator and the denominator. Simply divide those two numbers, round it up to two decimal points, multiply by 100, and now you've got the percentage, which is what this homework asks you to accomplish. So that's the homework. I understand this is a little challenging. So if you are working on this and if you're stuck at a certain point, please ask me a question. Like if you are in the middle of the week and you're working through this, tweet at me. I've been responding to tweets as often as I've been getting them. I'm also getting some messages sometimes on LinkedIn or Twitter, which I don't see very often. But if you tweet at me and if you tell me where you are stuck or what you're struggling with, or if you need ideas for how to accomplish a certain step, I'll be happy to share those ideas with you during the course of the week as well. And of course, on Friday, when we record our Q&A or homework video, I will write the code for how to accomplish this. That concludes all of week 4's videos. Thank you.